And maybe you can walk us through some of the things that you've been doing to put people at ease as you move them through your pipeline. Because I know you've got a different product set, but you know, we're basically doing the same thing right now, right? We're going in with the stuff that creates big result, high impact, low dollar, and building trust right now. And I think you've been doing the same thing, right?
Sure. There is a big opportunity right now because there are more eyes on the internet than ever before. Everybody's at home, right? The average person spends about 2.5 hours a day on social media platforms on a regular work week, on a regular Monday without the coronavirus. Their numbers, Facebook just came out with statistics, basically said they're over 130% more traffic and people being logged in. And the averages went from 2.5 hours to about 4.5 hours. So one thing that, you know, I told some of you guys before, and again, you know, you guys have a lot of options and possibilities. Nick's given you a ton of tools and things that you can go in and you can offer and you can talk about. What we've personally been doing is we've just really been hitting, when I first built my agency to the first 10,000 per month, like when I got myself to the first 10,000, about 80% of that was all social media management. It's pretty low hanging fruit. Everybody knows they need to be on social. And now even more than ever, right now specifically, social media is a great, it's a really easy sales, low hanging fruit. If you're on social media yourself, I know you guys probably scroll through Facebook and Instagram and all that stuff just like I do. You're seeing a lot of people capitalize on one of the things that Nick mentioned to you guys on our call last week. How do we help certain businesses be able to sustain themselves during this time off? So I've got a lot of restaurant partners, and they're doing the curbside pickup and drive through, and some of them are even doing delivery through. And some of them that weren't doing delivery before have went and created new accounts with a lot of the food delivery companies, just so that they can be capitalizing on this niche. So we're showing them how to roll that out. We've got a doctor that we're setting up on teleservices. It's one of you partners out there that I'm working with. We've got a doctor that one of his biggest things is he wants to start doing teleservices and really promoting that. And if you're on social media, you're probably seeing a lot of these same types of posts. Some people are running ads based around this. There's in the health and fitness genre, a lot of the personal trainers are starting virtual classes and virtual training. So there are still people that are finding ways win, even though people can't come to their business. You just have to find ways to be able to get creative. I know some of you guys are really dialed into certain niches, and some of those niches you might not be able to help. So you may have to think outside the box during this time. Some of the businesses that you can help get, you know, continue to grow and scale their business. So I just mentioned several of them to you guys right there. Everybody's promoting telehealth services right now. Everybody's trying to, look at ways that they can still service their clients through this time of, social distancing, right?